increasingly, we're faced with more complicated, complex tumors, larger tumors, and tumors that are in close proximity. They're very close to critical structures. For instance, say the optic chiasm or the brainstem or one of the major cranial nerves. And giving a single fraction would be problematic, would cause too much of a side effect. And so the technologies that we have today with our relocatable frame, with our image guidance, on our ability to vary the intensity of the radiation beam has allowed us to give an effective dose of radiation by breaking it up into smaller fractions, something called hypofractionation. For instance, for the smallest tumors, we may give 21 or 24 gray, and that's a measure of radiation, in a single fraction. But for a tumor that's, say, 3 centimeters, we may give you a much lower dose, which is 16 gray. And that doesn't make any sense because a bigger tumor will have more cells that need to be killed. So why are we giving a lower dose? It's because if we tried to give 24 gray to that 3 centimeter tumor, the side effect, meaning swelling, necrosis, which is dying brain tissue, would be unacceptably high.
In between the treatments, the normal brain can repair. In between the treatments, some areas of the tumor that were more resistant to radiation, maybe because they weren't getting enough oxygen, can get more oxygen, become more sensitive to radiation.
All cells in the body require oxygen. And tumors themselves have a higher demand on oxygen consumption just because they're growing so rapidly. They can actually outgrow their blood supply. And when they outgrow their blood supply, they become what's called hypoxic. So there's little oxygen towards the centers of the tumor. Incidentally, by giving a smaller dose of radiation, but giving it in multiple fractions, we get the benefit of having the tumor shrink. And then that portion that was hypoxic actually has no more blood supply. And as it further shrinks, it gets even more blood supply. So the radiation is now more effective because there's more oxygen around, there's more free radical to damage the cancer cells, and you get a better response to treatment.
For some large tumors, the future might be to be giving 3 and 5 treatments as opposed to just 1 treatment. And again, if you have a system that doesn't rely on screwing something to the patient's head, then you have that flexibility of what's best for this tumor. If it's 3 treatments, we'll give 3 treatments. If it's 1, we'll give 1. And the quality and the accuracy will be the same.